As we were looking at pressure on the forwarder, we could hear a hissing sound from the tractor and realized that the plug that had been placed there earlier, I'm not sure if that was included in any of the repair videos, here you can see that rubber plug coming up, had started leaking again. We were hoping the damage on the tire inside there would survive with the plug until it was time to remove the chains from the tractor, but apparently not. So decision was made to put a tube inside it. I had already purchased the tube for it and was ready for it, but was gonna delay it if it held the air a little longer. So chain removed, rolled back and pushed up with the loader to be able to remove the tire. And then the little excavator was brought out, and I need to look at that coolant leak that is eluding me. Does anyone have any good suggestion how to find coolant leaks? I've seen suggestions to use some UV dye in the coolant, so you can use a UV light to start tracking the leak. They can be hard to spot when it's evaporating away if it leaks somewhere in a hot area. With the excavator we started pushing the tire off the rim, pushed in a few different spots to get some soapy water in there to help get it to come off the rim. We also did push it off the rim on the other side, but that was missed. Now we brought it inside to work in the garage with getting the tire off the rim. Used the lift and some wooden blocks here and there to help support the rim and support the tires. Once inside I added some more of this tire paste, a better lube, and then it was about wrestling the rubber off the rim. Have been doing my own motorcycle tires for years, and this actually wasn't a lot harder than that. And I had some tire irons that are on the big size for the motorcycle, and then we also incorporated some breaker bars for better leverage. Wasn't all that hard, it's just heavy things and giving it time to support things well. There is a valve in there that's kind of pulled into the hole in the rim that broke as we tried to pull it out, but another pliers, these kind of grab on pliers, and some more pulling it came out. We lifted things up again, let the rim kind of come out so we could clean things up a little, and then brought it back down to clean. Here we have some wood blocks under the rubber itself to get a gap here. Removed some old, it has been patched before, this tire from the inside, and there are some rubber leftovers. Unhappy with the cleaning, we ended up lifting it down on the floor. I missed the video where we actually started putting the tube inside there, but it was pushed into the tire, connected the valve stem to through the hole in the rim. I did add a lot of the talcum baby powder, can help kind of lubricate the tube, the inner tube, so it doesn't grab onto the tire or rim and can slide into its correct places. A lot of tire paste, and then here we only used the tire irons that has a hook at the end, using a breaker bar or something that does not have a hook at the end that can grab onto the rim. It's very easy to slide further in and damage the tube. And you push down the one side so the tire can go into the kind of valley of the rim, giving you clearance to get it on there. And to be honest, I think they are easier than motorcycle tires in the sense that the diameter is bigger. We started blowing things up. Did not have a valve core at first. We put it upright so you could see that the bead was seated fully all the way around the tire as we started inflating it. Cleaned up inside the garage some. And it was brought outside. It had lost a little pressure on the loader, or maybe the diameter of the tire was a little bigger now, fully inflated, so I think it could have sunk down the end of the bucket in the snow a little also, so had to start the tractor and lift it up a little to be able to get it in place. Add a little bit of Loctite to the nuts and tighten things up. My dad put back on the chain that was not included, but I think I've covered that in some previous video. Then the next issue. This was actually done before the tire issue, but my chronological order is not perfect for the videos. Had seen that some seals here on the steering arms have broken. No. We had issues getting things apart here. The place you could grab onto and hold would slip on the tools we had, so a big pipe wrench was added to hold on as we were able to undo the nut, securing things. And some heat was added, as you saw. Then it was just a matter of backing it all the way out until the wheel was free. We used some strap to hold the wheel out of the way as we tried replacing the seal. The old one was broken apart, so it came out in two pieces. Then I used a little bit of tape to, I don't think it was as critical here as if you put a seal on an axle that spins, that you secure it even if a minor damage would have been done here. It wouldn't have been the end of the world. I put in some really sticky grease I have around for applications like this. And then as I tried forcing it back on there, we had some fighter jets flying above us, as you can hear. This new seal was kind of stiff and a little hard to get to get seated in its correct place, and I ended up, but luckily it can spin so you can access it where it's easy to work with, because it's the end of the steering cylinder. And removed the tape, cleaned up some of this super sticky annoying grease, and then some lock rings to secure the boot, rubber boot on there. Two lock rings, a little tricky getting them seated where they should be, but taking a little care with the screwdriver, it was not too bad. And then it was just a matter of tightening things back up. Added some Loctite here also, holding things down as we secure the lock nut. I'd taken care to measure the number of threads showing before undoing it, so it could be put back in the same position. Same thing had to be done to the other side also, so just the same procedure. And they were both in places like this. I'm always worried that something will be threaded the wrong way, but here they are, both sides are normal threads. So more grease, putting things in place, getting the rubber boot on there. Nothing too hard. So. But they were quite expensive, these new rubber boots. Had my dad turn the steering to get it to come out a little further to be easier to get the boot in place. All done.